Okay, we lost our signal, so
Good morning again.
We're back again. Good morning. Happy Monday.
Are we the only people who have problems with technology?
I don't think so. Wi-Fi is a crapshoot. So anyway, good morning. I was just sharing a story about yesterday morning as I was walking by the tennis courts. I saw this young girl, like in her teens, and she had somebody who was, or she had a coach who was tossing the tennis ball to her. And this girl was so amazing. I'd never seen her up at our courts before, but she was hitting that ball like she was smacking it. And she's this tiny little petite thing. And yet she was hitting the ball harder than Paul can hit it. He's a really strong tennis player. So I was like, what is it? What is it that makes her able to hit that ball? She made it look so easy. Like any of us should be able to do it.
And so you're asking me.
I'm asking you. Why could she do it?
So the reason why professional athletes and trained athletes can hit the ball harder, no matter how skinny they are, how they don't look that fit, The reason is it's called the kinetic chain. And so the kinetic chain is what from when an athlete is, but I'm going to do it real fast here. So a kinetic chain is, so it's from the ground up and it's using the momentum of your body to create a chain, a whip-like action. And so from the ground up, it's a process. And so a professional athlete is trained to use their kinetic chain. And so how does that apply to sales or in business in general?
All right, so let's go back to kinetic chain for
yeah.
a second. And then because I do want to apply this, but when you think about this kinetic chain, I'm watching this girl and I'm thinking to myself, how is she hitting the ball as hard as she is, as this tiny little thing?
Yeah.
Now clearly it's because of this kinetic chain. She's got a sequence of events, right? She's got every single muscle moving in perfect harmony in sequence and synchronicity even, right?
Right.
In order to produce this kind of whipping motion. But she makes it look so simple.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, and it's not only in tennis, but it's in golf. And, you know, golf, baseball, like we were watching the Cubs last night, which was a heartbreaker. And I'm getting tired of staying up late and watching them lose.
And crying in your Cheerios.
But you watch pitchers, you watch athletes in general, but they create this whip-like action with their bodies, and that's all part of the kinetic chain. Now, some people have it naturally, but most people have to be trained how to maximize the kinetic chain properly and to get the best results from it.
So
it's a process.
So I got to tell you, I was actually looking to see who her coach was throwing the ball, and what's going through my head is, oh, well, maybe if I had Paul throw me the ball like that instead of hit to me, maybe then I could hit like that. Like, fooling myself into thinking that it was the way the ball was thrown to her. But then I go to, ooh, I wonder who her coach is and whether he could teach me that sequence of events that he's clearly taught her.
Yeah.
Because here's what I think happens. As a recreational player, I've learned some really bad habits. I've taught myself a lot of those bad habits because I haven't invested in the proper coaching to teach me the step-by-step, where your feet are, where your hips are, where your motion is.
Yeah, but a lot of it is, I mean, little kids, most of these professional athletes have started off as children. So they've been taught from the very beginning. So if you are going to change your game and become really good at what you do and add that kinetic chain to your play, then you really have to start from the foundation down. You have to really break down what you're currently doing, put that aside, and start all over from the foundation and using a process and having somebody who's done it before teach you how to do it.
Right. So if you think about that, as adults in any sport we play or in anything we do for that matter in business, we have already potentially learned some bad habits. And yet then there are people out there who are really awesome at what they do. If we could only really understand the step-by-step process that they go through and model it, and then practice it with consistency. This is where I think it really applies to business.
Yeah.
And if you take sales as an example, what is the kinetic chain of sales, right? It is that every sales has a process. So the question is, as a salesperson, if you're in sales, are you using your step-by-step process and in order and with the right momentum, or are you just swinging at it, right? Like, are you just swinging at it?
Well, and that's the difference between, just like it is for the difference between a professional athlete and a recreational player. using that kinetic chain, using the process that's trained and repetitive, gives them the edge. That's what makes them the premier athletes. Mm-hmm. Same thing in sales. If you're somebody who's just a wreck sales person that's out there, and you're just swinging for the fences all the time, and you don't really have a process that's going on, you kind of just wing it as you go along, that's sort of like the wreck tennis player, or wreck golf, or wreck baseball or softball player.
So here's the point, yep. is if you are recreational at sales, you are just swinging. Or, by the way, recreational at leadership, as a manager, in whatever your role is at work, right? Are you recreational, or are you a pro, where you're actually learning, training, working the step-by-step in the right order with the right mindset, right? There's all of those things that line up, but it's practice so that ultimately when you practice it enough, it actually is absorbed into your subconscious mind. That girl I know who was playing on the courts, she was not thinking about every movement of her muscle. That was ingrained in her body because she's probably hit that shot 50,000 times already. Right. So
the point is, for you out there, that if you don't currently have a process in your sales, and let's face it, everybody's in sales no matter what you're doing, any opportunity you get a chance, what process are you using to maximize the results of closing that sale, of getting the business?
All right. So with that, I hope you guys have an awesome week and be thinking about, share for us any thoughts that you have, how this whole kinetic chain idea applies to your business. See if you can come up with any ways that you can school us on how this kinetic chain works for you. All right?
You all have a great week.
Have a great week.
Thanks for joining us.
Good to see you. Thanks for joining. Take care.
Bye now.